A common challenge in VFX is how to get a good motion track when your objects get secluded or obscured by something in the foreground. Thankfully, the Mocha layer system for planar tracking is designed to give artists the tools they need to solve even the most difficult tracks. There are multiple masking techniques that can assist a planar track. Here I prepared a couple of examples to help explore which technique works best for different types of shots. For our first example, we want to track and replace the content on a laptop screen. Screen replacements are one of the most common VFX tasks nowadays. So even if you're a video editor, it's still nice to have that extra skill of doing simple screen replacements in your arsenal. First, let's draw a tracking shape around the whole screen and see what results we would get if we don't isolate what's inside. Let's also set up our surface tool. I'm trying to do it as precise as I can. This shot has slight perspective changes, so I'll also enable perspective tracking checkbox. Now we are ready for our first try. It may look pretty good at the beginning, but when the woman starts to move her head to the side, our planar surface is thrown off. To explain more, the shape is the search area, and Mocha is expecting all the pixels within the shape to move as one plane. Often the content on the screen is moving independently, so we want to subtract the screen from our tracking area. This is when the Add X-Spline tool will be your best choice. If you go up here and click and hold on the Create X-Spline tool icon, you will get a few other tool choices. You can choose the Add X-Spline tool by picking this option with a little plus near the cross, or alternatively, just by hitting Command-G or Ctrl-G on your keyboard. By having this tool selected, any new shape you draw will live on the same layer. And by adding a second shape within the area of the first one, you're literally making a hole and saying to Mocha, don't use anything in this subtraction area. Now this section would be ignored. If you enable visibility on the layer mats, you will see how the subtracted shape focuses Mocha only on the pixels we want to track. I'll enable the surface tool back and try to track again. Now we get much better results and can apply that to our new insert. Here I prepared my new screen in a separate precomp. And now I need to select that precomp in Mocha settings. Don't forget to choose the corresponding layer inside the Mocha plugin itself. Hit save. And here's how it looks when we render that with the insert module. If you're using Mocha AE and don't have access to the insert module, you can generate the tracking data and apply that as a corner pin to your insert precomp layer. After hitting apply export, you would get a corner pin effect as a last effect on your insert precomp layer. And here's our final result. Making cutouts with the Add X-Spline tool are also handy while working with Power Mesh and faces. It is recommended to subtract the eyes and the mouth, so the blinking and mouth movements won't lead to unnecessary mesh warping. Just make a cutout on the same layer, generate the mesh on the frame that has least amount of distortion, and you're ready to go. With the help of Power Mesh, you can create digital makeup, and the only limit is your imagination. Let's take a look at another example. We need to track this wall, but there are two persons walking into the frame and occluding parts of the wall. I can't use the central part of the image because at one point girls meet in center. There are also huge shadows and I don't want them to affect my track. So I think the best section to track would be the top part of the image. We only need to exclude girls' heads. Making cutouts won't work for this one, and there are few reasons why. In the previous example, the main object and the inside distractions were mostly at the same distance from the camera and also moving in the same relative direction. Think of them as parent and child objects. While in this shot, both girls are walking towards each other and the wall is a completely different plane. We won't be able to successfully track all this in one layer as there is a lot of competing motion. The second reason to break this into multiple layers is that the occluding object, in our case a person, is not fully inside the wall shape. If you try adding another shape on the same layer and turn on layer mats, look what happens. You partially make a cutout where the shapes are overlapping, but at the same time, you add more area to track where they do not overlap. Now I'll delete all this and let's do it the right way. Making separate layer masks for each girl on different layers would be the best way to go. I'll simply draw two circles around their heads, rename layers accordingly, and now everything is set up to track in one click of a button. notice that our layer order is important. The wall track is at the bottom because it is the furthest object from the camera. Stacking layer mask like this automatically gives you subtract masks based on the order of the layers. See how different the mat looks if I change the layer order. And now let's try to track. Sticking pretty good now. If you want to put a logo behind somebody, you do not necessarily need to track the exact same area where you want the logo to be. It does not matter what area you're tracking, as long as the surface is coplanar. Just analyze the shot, see if there is a trackable area without occlusions, and draw your shape there. In this example, I would select an area slightly left to the center, so we really don't need to draw any subtraction mask around the guy. We'll simply avoid him, then offset our track. Let's create track data and apply that to the null object. Link the logo layer to the null, and now I can position it anywhere on the wall I want. Need to spend some time to comp it better. I'm using the layer style called Bevel and Emboss and just trying to find the parameters that look best to my eye. I also duplicated the logo layer, added a bit of lens blur, and reduced the opacity, just to make the area around the logo look a bit darker. After we wrote the guy, our final result looked like this. Can you guess what is tricky about this shot? If you look more closely at the table, you may notice that the countertop is literally a mirror that reflects everything around it. We have almost no texture to grab. Reflections and shadows are two of your main enemies. You may not notice them at first glance, until you realize that everything is going wrong when your track has already been thrown off. This shot is quite an extreme example, but much less explicit reflections may still affect your track. That's because reflections are almost always reflecting off a different plane, and trying to track them along with the main object leads to competing motion that will always throw things off. So the rule of thumb is to avoid reflections when you're choosing where to draw your shapes. Thankfully, there was somebody on the production set who knew how VFX works, so they put these markers on the table. Because the surface of this table is coplanar, we can easily track these markers, and the track data will be relevant for the whole surface. So I'm drawing my shapes only around the markers that I can clearly see with an AdjustTrack tool again, and also including this non-reflective table edge. I will set up the surface tool only for the half of the table, because I know that later I would want to put two different inserts in front of each girl. I believe these two central markers are located relatively on the same line, so I use them as my main guides. Choosing to track perspective and giving it a first try. Not bad for the start, but we have a little bit of drifting. How can we fix it? At this point, I decided to try preprocessing. Because the footage looks so flat, at first I thought that this white table edge was too smooth for getting good tracking results. But after I adjusted the contrast and gamma, I saw that there actually is some texture to track. So I added one more small shape between the girls here to fix the drifting of the front left corner. That made it stick better, but at one point my surface tool started to jump. That's because the shadow from the girl's hand started to interrupt my track. So what I did, I set it up a keyframe right before the surface tool starts to jump, and one frame forward, I moved the shape even further along the bar. And continued to track. When the shape started to go out of frame, I made another keyframe and moved the shape again. This feature looks good to me now, because it will continue to move over the black background till the end of the shot, so I move my shape here. Okay, this one nailed down, let's fix the others. The far end of the table is in defocus, so it will be easier to manually adjust the drifting in the AdjustTrack tab than trying to retrack it. The AdjustTrack module is the tool that allows us to amend our tracking data by making precise corrections over the top of the base track. Here I'll choose Perspective Transform type to automatically create four reference points, one in each corner of the surface, even though I only really need to fix two of them. I set up the first frame to be the reference frame and scroll ahead to the end of the shot where the mismatch is most significant. Now I can manually move the points and align the surface properly. Great! I'll scroll through the shot a couple of times to check whether there's still any noticeable drift. The nudge keys can also be used to make precise pixel-by-pixel adjustments in a predetermined direction. I selected the needed reference point, and while looking at the small zoom window in the upper left corner of the screen, I continued hitting the nudge right button a couple of times until I was satisfied with the results. Alright, the surface looks good to me now. The corrected result can be exported as a corner pin right from the AdjustTrack tab. Here inside After Effects, I created a new solid layer, turned it into a precomp, and pasted the Mocha corner pin data to it. The first half is ready. Let's jump back into Mocha again and set up the other half. As I mentioned before, the whole surface of the table is coplanar, which means we do not have to retrack anything. The only thing we need to do is just realign the surface tool to make it cover the other half of the table. So I duplicated the table layer, positioned the surface as I wanted, and repeated the export process for the second precomp. Perfect, the placeholders are ready. Now I can just drag and drop any desired assets into those precomps and everything sits in place perfectly. After fixing the colors and adding a little bit of lens blur to the inserts, here's what we're starting to get. I repeated the same process for this back wall, but drawing shapes around the markers and avoiding the reflections. Then made another precomp and assembled my third screen inside. As the final touch, I used BCC looks for color correction, starting with a color reversal preset. After that, I added just a little bit of BCC film glow to emulate the emission from the screens. I also keyed out these two green windows with key light and put an Earth image there, to kinda make it feel like they're operating some futuristic spaceship. Overall, after finishing all the steps, here's what I was able to get. I think it ended up looking pretty cool, and it was really fun and easy to create it with the help of powerful Boris FX tools. And that's all for today. If you liked this video, please hit the like button below and subscribe to Boris FX YouTube channel to get more videos like this. Follow to borisfx.com or visit our forums to get more information about Mocha Pro and other Boris products. Thanks for staying with me today. See you later!